Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Jurassic World the Game, where today we have the Shake the Earth which is actually just a little Zalmoxes. So this is the new tournament creature. It's a herbivore and I can't wait for it because I don't think we've had a herbivore tournament creature. I could be wrong, hold on. Because if you guys play this, you know the herbivores are extremely underpowered. Sorry, no, I'm very wrong. We have had herbivores. We've got the legendary Antarctica Pelta, the Dinocerus, or Dinocerus. I think somebody actually told me how to pronounce it in a comment one, and I've completely forgotten it. Sorry. I ain't no paleontologist, I'm a guy sits on his bum playing games. We also have the Ulycosaurus, which is a recent one that also got the best hybrid, the Ulyphosaurus. We have Pachyrhinosaurus and Kentrosaur, which were WWE exclusive if you bought the packs and donated money to charity. However, I think they will probably be tournament creatures. In fact, they may already have been. But out of all of these, really the best is Antarctica Pelta, but it's not, because Ankylodocus is still the best. So chances are Zalmoxes will probably fit in somewhere here. I think we'll be very impressed if Zalmoxes turns out to be one of the best herbivores, because usually hybrids are, but the good thing is it's another hybrid, and it's our first theropod herbivore, but it's not. Dinocerus and Dinocerus, Ulycosaurus, and I'm pretty sure we got quite a few other herbivores that stand on two legs, like Parasaurolophus, like Pelecomimus. Yeah, like Carithosaurus, Gallimimus, I'm an idiot. I was thinking maybe there's a reason why they're bringing it in, because it could hybridize with something else. Or be I don't even know how hybridizes will, but it's what I'm going to call it. Anyway, we are doing it exactly on the dot. That's why it says 6 days and 0 hours. So we'll get it right on here. So as soon as we win a battle, we're going to get to number one, see how long it takes. It's probably only going to take like 20 minutes max. The thing is though, we have to scroll all the way to really underpowered creatures. Otherwise, tell you what, Soda, actually, because the thing is, we're going to be facing pretty naff dinosaurs. I think as long as the tournament hasn't changed, there'll be level commons, level 10 commons. Yeah, there you go. And you have to put in the same dinosaurs, or else you will only win 20 cups. But the thing is, it would take me so long to scroll down to find a dinosaur that is worthy of it that we're probably not going to find it. So I'd rather put in this. Get, you know, two matches in where it would take maybe, you know, one match. So we'll get 40 cups, and you know, you can't really get 40 cups unless you're incredibly underpowered. So I'd rather just do some quick battles and just ramp it up, because as soon as we win this, you went for Fluffy! No, bad Fluffy! Fluffy died of quackers! I'm a lunatic! This is what you gotta realize by now. You've been watching, you know, for 2 years, Jurassic World for 2 years, hats off to you. That's some major staying power. I love Dilophosaurus when it looks like this. I really do. It looks so knobbly, and it looks so, like its skull is so sunken, and it looks beautiful. It looks all brittle and bony. I love when it looks like that. Yeah, you won. You guess how much you won? 20 cups, I bet. Oh, would you believe that? Where do you think we're going to end up? Have a guess. Are we going to go straight into the common? Are we going to go into rare, super rare, legendary, or all-star? What are we going to go with? I'm going to say rare. I say we're going to completely miss out common. Oh, yes! There it is, Survivor League 81. I knew it. Survivor whale unlocked. So, one thing we haven't seen, like the wheel. Yeah, the wheel is the same. I was wondering because, I don't know, we've got better wheels for the PvP. Maybe the tournament would change as well. But, no, it hasn't. But we actually won DNA as well as, food and VIP points, which isn't too bad at all. And, you know, as the further we move up, the better prizes we get. So let's keep on going. So now we're in rare league. So we're looking at about level 30 to 40 rares. So I would say this team's in with a shot, I'd say. I do need to max out Labyrinthosaurus and Pelicanopteryx, or at least get into level 30. Oh, it's level 30 rares. I thought maybe level 40, but we could almost kill Giga in one hit. It's so close. He'll probably switch. And he does to the hybrid Labyrinthosaurus. But we can kill it in two hits, unfortunately. Bam. We're probably only going to get 20 cups for the first few battles until we can, you know, go up here. But that's okay, because we're never going to use these creatures anyway, and we get to see them! Like level 40 super rares, otherwise we'll probably completely bypass them. He goes for one block, so he just survives with about 5 health. Oh, you lucky ducky, you. Oh, goes for the switch. Can Gallimimus, blue Gallimimus, take it on? Now, that's the thing. Gallimimus has changed a lot since his first debut. He was completely blue. Now he's like a navy blue. He was like luminescent, dark, bright blue. It was weird. Can you get luminescent dark? It's a thing now, according to me. Oh, I think he killed him. He did. Oh, hats off to you, Giga. That's good. Good job, my friend. Good job. But you've only got 5 health left. And what used to be my favorite dinosaur, Parasaurolophus, takes you out. Now, the thing is, people are going to be like, what? It's not your favorite anymore? It's not, actually. But I don't have a favorite dinosaur. Like, Parasaurolophus was my favorite dinosaur when, like, I never really thought about dinosaurs and he was my go-to. But now dinosaurs is an everyday kind of thing. So I see all these new and wonderful creatures, all these wonderful dinosaurs, and I'm thinking, is it still Parasaurolophus? It's probably not, but I haven't found a replacement. I haven't found a dinosaur that's so cool, I'm like, that's my favorite, that's my new favorite. If anything, it would probably be something like Carnoraptor or Indominus, but they're not real dinosaurs, so that doesn't really count. So we'll put in a team of Indominus Rexes! Because we have moved to the top of the Survivor League. Yeah, it's funny, like, the tournament has the sound effects from the Lost World Jurassic Park from the PlayStation 1 game when you put in your password, and that's when it goes brrrr all the way through. And also, if you remember in that game, every time you complete a level, you get a survivor, you get like a title, like Survivor, Prey, Predator. And that's what these are as well in the tournament leagues. So, it's not just one coincidence. You got two things from a certain game in the tournament by itself, which is really strange to me. I kind of like it. It's like a little, oh, look, it's not just a coincidence. There's another thing. It's these little Easter eggs, you see. It's like in Jurassic World, the amount of Easter eggs. I'll probably do that at one point. All the Easter eggs that are sort of put in. I kind of wanted to do that, but I also didn't want to get, like, copyright struck by Universal. Because, you know, I have no interaction with them, which sucks. Because I would really like to do something with them. Whether, you know, it's working on a game or promoting something. I would really love to get in touch with them. Or even going to see the premiere of Jurassic World 2. I'd love to work on them with something. Anything. And, I would imagine they, like, I'm not being a big-headed, but I'd imagine they would have heard of me. I mean, this is their game. Surely they would have at least once Google searched it and found my video, because, you know, that's kind of all I did when it first was released. It was Jurassic World. So there we go. Oh, it's a level 66 even. I can't do that. That's the Lady and the Tramp Beaver, and I can't even do a 60. I can't do the whistle blowing through the teeth. So, out of all the prizes we won, that's probably been the worst. But, you know, I kind of need coin right now, so I'm not going to object. I know, right? How times have changed. The beaver. Yep. Regrets ever saying stuff like that. So we have Pachyceratops, Kentrosaurus, and Indominus Rex, because we have 4 of those. Which we could all sell those Indominus Rexes for about... How much is he? He's about 20,000 DNAs, 29,000 or something. So we could get about 60,000 DNA from those, but it's not worth it, because I'd rather have an Indominus Rex than get a hot, let you know, sell 4 for the price of 2. I would rather keep the 4. Because I don't even know how I won this. I think that's right, because the trade harbor used to be good. Because I remember getting Indominus Rex for trades for coin. I loved it. I got some Kool-Aids as well, Super Kool-Aid, sorry. But ever since then, I've never seen them come back. Recently, right now in the trade harbor, there's loads of trades for coin. And I don't mean a little coin. It's all coin. It's like double or nothing. It's like 47 million coin. Half your, you know, the coin you can hold in the entire park, you know, in your actual coin purse. You could place down loads of John Hammond statues and have them as extra gold, because you can do that, like I've done, if you're a smart cookie. But, yeah, and tell you what, the prices, the trade you trade that much gold, ugh, I can't even talk, 47 million gold trades for good prizes. It's like 4,000 DNA or 6,000 DNA, which I'm happy to do so. A couple of those trades can buy you an Indominus Rex. You've just got to keep on top of it and keep on generating coin. That's all you've got to worry about. The trade harbor will see you through. Don't worry, my friend. And there you go. I didn't even concentrate on the battle. I sort of knew if I could kill it or not. An alien ripoff! Ridley Scott! Pachyceratops wins it! Oh, 22 that time! Breaks the mold! So, yep, we're almost in a Predator League already. Again, Hunter League prize wheel has not been kind to me. It's got to be said, just give me coin. So, God, that gave me a shock. You're back in! Right, okay. Indominus, Prion Sutures. I think it's only fair to do this. Actually, if we leveled up the Indominus Rexes, the other four, we could have 6 Indominus Rexes at level 10. It was just like, I should do that because I was getting food at one point and it was going to waste. Like right now, my food harbor is almost ready. Or sorry, food depot, whatever you want to call it. It's almost ready to collect. But you see, it would be completely wasted. In fact, actually, I should do that. We'll do that because I was on 99 million at one point. We'll collect it. So we're going to kill this thing. I don't care if it's got one block. It does. And do we kill it? Bow, just. That's good, because that's the only amphibian they've got, and we've got 2 Indominus Rexes, and the only other dinosaur that can stand up to them is Sacabonkabonkasaurus, which is actually dead, so it's only up to the Dino Cherries. Oh, he's like, oh, lame. And Bosog, oh, to all my Filipino fans out there, I'm Pinoy. And we might as well kill it. Pretty darn easy. Whoa-boosh! Awesome. Right, that should take us to the Predator League. 22 again, so yeah, it was about right the same creatures. Where we're gonna be? Ah, pretty low, 88. So, but maybe top 5% of people, you know, this isn't F goal. This isn't Hungry Shark World where it is legitimately people. So if you're not in the top 1%, well, that's because you're not very, you're not the top 1%. But in this game, you can be the top 1% because everybody is the top 1%. I was going to say the DNA would have been good, but we're going to get the food, which isn't too bad because we kind of need that. Let's first put in Giga because I'm just selling those and collect the food harbor. Yum, yum. And keep on going on the tournament. We're on Predator League right now. So now we're here. We're talking about Pekiizers and Unicorn Wizard status now. 500 about attack. 500-ish, I'd say. Level 40 legendaries. This is probably where people grow. Oh my god, Metrocanthosaurus! We've killed it in one hit. It's actually not really that good. Look, maybe Unicorn Wizard won't. Oh, it goes first. Who knows? Maybe it will be used. Oh, it might be. Woo-woo-saurus! Has nothing, but has 2. Can't kill us. It might go for an attack, though. Doesn't. Okay, we're going to go for a full-on 4 reserve here. So he's wasted all of his goes either blocking or switching dinosaurs in. Good start. Again, I never face anybody who's VIP ever. Because these are all bots, and apparently Ludia's like, nah, nobody buys VIP. Not even the bots buy it. So brings in the Metrocanthosaurus again. It does have a lot of attack, though, to be honest, for its health. Tells about the same. Oh, goes for a full-on attack. Yeah, that's killed us. However, this Pekiizers is replaced with another Pekiizers. Ah, my balls. So we're going to go for 1 attack. 4 reserves, 1 block. And I'm pretty sure it can't touch me. Ceratosaurus, let's have a look. 200 attack. I don't think he can kill me if we went for a full-on 4. Unfortunately, Unicorn Wizard, you're not going to be seen today, but you helped. You did help. Let's go for a full-on 8.
Eyeballs as a duckies!
Oh, he went for a full-on 4. Bless him, he tried. And again, if you see there, the tongue sticking out the bottom of the jaw, still not fixed. I think it's just an in-joke. They're like, we'll just leave that in there, just to annoy the beaver. Doesn't work, damn it. Doesn't work! It doesn't affect, I swear! So, 88 to 60. Wow, we're gonna have to do 2 battles. Hopefully a better prize this time. Another 40. So let me get this straight. Survivor League gave me 2 gold prizes. This gives me 2. Sorry, Predator League gives me 2 food prizes. All exactly the same, by the way. So let's see. We've moved up a little bit more. Troodon, T-Rex, and Ceratosaurus go on. 700 attack. Because that might have been a really weak Predator League team. Oh, and it was. Look at that.
Scapa booblies.
We can kill it in two hits if it goes first. Come on, go first. It does. Come on. Hit me or switch. Woo! Should we do it? Should we risk the biscuit? Damn it. Oh, no. It still takes two hits to kill him. Nuts. But he can't kill me into it, so that's okay. What a waste. Damn it. Go for two reserves. T-Rex can take on everything. And then Super Kool-Aid. Ah, don't worry about it. It's fine. Four. Oh, it's still not going for anything. It's a full-on reserve battle here. Got six. Although, the computer always goes for some block. It's always like some. Or very rarely goes for an all-out reserve. It's always like, maybe one block. Maybe a little bit. So we went for a full-on attack there. One, two, full reserve, two block. Awesome. Brings in the dragon. Level 20 hybrid, actually. This is about 532 attack. Still, like, on par with the T-Rex, though. That's crazy. That's a legendary hybrid. I guess it's a regular legendary hybrid. But still, a T-Rex is better than at level 20. That's amazing. T-Rex is so good. And we've killed that one. Brings on the one I'm not looking forward to, which has about the same attack, actually. Yeah, 599. Super Kool-Aid. The only thing is, it nerfs us. And if T-Rex gets killed, which he's probably going to do by going for 6. Oh, no, 5. He's got 2 block. Ceratosaurus' attack's really not that good. Oh, my God. 200. Right, he's got 2 block, but I'm pretty sure we can kill it. 1, 2, 3, 4 kills it, and then he's only got like 2 block. We got 3. Oh, that was lucky, though. If he had one more block... Actually, we still would have killed him. We needed 2 more block. But that was lucky, though. That battle could have went either way, because Super Kool-Aid could have sweeped everything because it nerfed us. And the same amount of attack as, you know, its other dinosaur team, but when it nerfs you, it really hinders you. Oh, 30, almost, we can get to top 1%, easy. Oh, 80 bucks, I'll take it. That's reimbursed me for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 battles, awesome. Oh wait, no, 16 battles because it costs 5 bucks to enter, awesome. Sorry, I'm an idiot. Ooh, if you didn't know that already. Where have you been? So, God, these guys are way too strong though. Yeah, we'll go for that. 1,000 attack for Pterodostro. Oh, that's nuts. I was a bit annoyed that the VIP, they haven't done anything different yet. It's still just a regular legendary pack. The VIP only. You should win, like, a solid gold pack. But saying that, I don't think a solid gold pack really gives you good prizes. I think, you know, it gives you, you know, a tournament creature. But legendary pack gives you better VIP points, better DNA, better bucks. So... there's not really too much they could do. This is a really good team, actually, because our Pterodostro could almost kill this Kool-Aid in two hits, this Super Kool-Aid. And then we've got the actually, we don't want to use Tiny Colossaurus. We don't want to lose it just yet. If it happens, it happens. Ooh! Oh, so close! He's got 2 block. You know what? Sod it. Let's bring in the bad boy. The weird fish lips. So, and there we go. 2 reserve. He didn't go for 2 block, actually. Damn. That's a 2. We could have got 4 reserves instead of 2. But you never can tell. It's always good to be safe. He has to kill us in 3 hits. If he's got 6, he's probably going to go for 5. Yep, he's probably going to go for 5. Is he? He goes for 5. Yep, thought so. Right, so he's got 1 block, but that's okay. That's okay. We can kill him in 2, so we only have to go for 3. Yeah. And did he have that 1 block? He didn't. Okay, this is where it gets a bit dangerous. Because Dinocerus has a lot of attack, even nerfed. And then it's going to be unnerfed, so it's going to have double that. It's going to have about 800 attack when Pelicomimus comes in. It's going to go for... goes for 3. He's got 2 block. We should have won this. I don't know how much attack it has. Ah, 500. Yeah, it kills it in 2. Easy. 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 7. Awesome.
Banana Beak is me.
Actually, no, Banana Beak's something else. I think that's the Decindericus. Yeah, but you look like you got a banana anyway. You can be Banana Beak too. It's an interesting creature. Is it a flyer? It's like Rampharhynchus, isn't it? That tail. How could you forget it? So 29. We got loads. We got 30 there. Oh, there we go. Place 100. Right, now we just need to get to level 1. Top percent. Top 1 of the 1%. Oh, a quarter pack! Oh, that would be so good! Oh, the 500 bucks would be great, but you know what? I'll take the mystery pack, because you can get a variety. Although that was really close. Yeah, I don't mind that. That's okay. Oh, but the 500 bucks, though, that would be really good. Well, already, good prizes. We've won a mystery pack, which is better than, you know, most of the other things we've won. So, now we're in this league. I'll put in the Apatosaurus first, just to soak up hits, because that's what that thing kind of does. And then we'll put in Scappers. Got another health tank. I'll put in Therizinosaurus because, in case things go really bad and it's all carnivores. Oh, that's not good because, yeah, we've got herbivores, but, you know, the sweeper, which is the, Scappers, is not good against herbivores. And that's what they've got. And they've got good ones. So, come on, dude. You can't take on a Patasaur. You can't kill E.T. Look at it. Looks dopey. It's awesome. Because it's dopey. 400. Right. I'm not going to kill it. A Apatosaur has one job here. And that's to stay alive. And to absorb hits. Oh, there you go. He's only got 2 block. Oh, we could open up here. Because we've got 8. Oh, we got 7. Oh, should we? Should we? I don't think we should. Not just yet. Not just yet. Come on. Go for 6. Go for 6. I don't think he can kill us. Oh, he goes for it! Yes, survive! Come on, Apatosaur! Awesome! Right. Let's do it. Let's kill it. 1, 2, 3, 4, you're dead, and 4 reserves! Awesome. You see, that's Apatosaur's plan. That's how you gotta play it. You've gotta absorb the hits, get the reserves, but also play a little bit clever with the blocks. And you can get the advantage straight away. And look at that. Screw it, just kill it! 8! Rah! Bam! So he's gonna have like 7 for Unicorn Wizard, Evil Unicorn Wizard when it comes in. And he's probably gonna kill us in like 2 hits. Yeah, he's going to. Now, what we need to do here is play very carefully. Actually, even just 1 hit. Well, you did good. We're at a massive disadvantage, but I bet he's gonna waste loads of blocks. So Scabbers is really the only one that can stand up. Therizinosaurus has terrible attacks. We're gonna switch him in and go for loads of reserves. Oh, he's got 8. He's gonna go for like 5 or 6. Probably 6. 5. Okay, 1, 2, that's 3 block. Yeah, we've done it. We've got, you know, 3 block already in our reserves, and then we've got 4 attack. We can kill him in 3. So we were 1 in the clear no matter what he does. And he only went for 2 block anyway. Awesome. He obviously thought he was going to survive. Silly noob!
Tricks of a scabber, boobies!
And that's it! Match, game, set, 1!
Me, scabber!
I know, I'm a nutcase. Oh, 34!
What can I say? I like doing silly voices.
85. Beautiful. Any a good prize this time? Oh, 50 bucks, I'll take it. Awesome! That's 10 matches worth of going in, so I think that's probably just paid for all the ones we've done just now, and the 80 bucks we got before has helped out towards the ones we're going to do. The higher we climb, the worse it's going to get, and it's going to get worse pretty darn quick. So 900 attack is probably safe bet. Because I feel like with All-Star, it varies massively. Absolutely. Like, that's an easy team. But it could have easily been Prytorodon level 30 with 1,000 attack. It could have very easily been that. So, they get to go first. Switch in a Apatosaur. Go on. Oh, goes for 1 attack. That's awesome. We killed it.
Silly berries. They're mine.
That would be awesome. Berries with a mascot for a cereal. Just some kid pouring out,
"Yay, Mom, a new cereal."
And pours it out, and then Berries smashes into the window.
Berries, bah!
And this is like a 5-second advert.
Berries, good for your kids.
Oh, you went for an attack as well. You little bugger, you. I'll attack you back. Bam. You see, now, the reason I attacked there is because it still takes 1 hit to kill him. So it didn't even matter if he blocked 1, I can still kill him. Oh, God. However, now Megalosaurus is dead, but still, it only takes two to kill him with Antarctic Pelter. So that's awesome. Boosh. Otherwise, he would have been in a bit of trouble, but he's killed him quite easily. Apatosaur is not... Like, Apatosaur in last is probably the worst thing you could do. I mean, look at it. It goes for four and only did 1,700. Whereas if I go for four, I can do 4,000 damage, which is double your health, mate. Well, 4,000 and a bit. I'll not get into logistics. Oh, we can get to number one. Easy. Easy GG. Yeah, I can trash talk. 30 cups. We're getting even more as we're getting closer. Oh no, it's slowing down loads. No. Come on, better prizes. A mystery? Yeah, I'll take the mystery. So it's a mystery pack, 50 bucks, another mystery pack. I think a mystery pack should be minimum what you win. I really do. I think it should just be packs. I mean, if I win a mystery pack every time, I'd be happy. Oh God, I don't know. Spinoraptor, I'll tell you what. Apatosaurus, Carnoraptor, and Pachyrhinosaurus. Again, same tactic. Apatosaurus out first. A sort of another meat shield with Pachyrhinosaurus, but Carnoraptor is the one that I want to get the kills with. Unfortunately, ... has gotten a Mastodonosaurus, which is kind of terrifying. But we can almost kill this thing in one hit. He'll probably switch. He does. But that means we get to go on the reserves. Come on. Come on, what are you going to do? Look at him. He's thinking. Look at that picture. He's thinking. Four reserve. That's good. We're good. We're good already. He's got five. Which is so sucky because he's already switched out and he's got higher turns than us. So let's go for some attack. Ah, come on! Well, that's okay. He's only got six. Whereas we're going to have eight. Right. What should we do? Should we take it out? Yeah, sod it. Whatever. Oh, I think that may have just been enough. I didn't even know how much extra I factored in. I was like, I don't care. Just kill it. Because then his pterodactyl's coming in and he's going to waste a go switching out. Or is he going to attack? Oh, the phone goes for seven. Oh, he's got balls. I'll give him that. He's got some major coconuts. Good on him. Taking out a parasol like that. What do you think you're doing? You big silly doof. I'm going to kill you now. Even if you block for one, which you did, you're dead. Right, Carnoraptor might die here. Level 20 is pretty beast. Yep, 1,000 attack. He could die. Don't do it. Oh, he does it. Well, it doesn't matter. He's dead anyway. Pachyrhinosaurus has like 500. Yeah, almost 600. Level 40 would probably have about 600 and odd attack, which would be good, but it would be like a better version of this. It's not amazing. It's not like a huge step. It's just a little bit better. And unfortunately, I've got Ankylodocus to fill in that slot. It would be nice to have another one, though. Another 30 cups. Is 30? I think 30 is the most you can get. Oh, flying through now. 62. Come on, good price. 500 DNA. Awesome. 500 DNA, 50 bucks, and two mystery packs so far. That's pretty darn good. Good trade. For like the $5 we're putting in. I mean, we are using our best creatures, I suppose. But we need to do this anyway to win the creature. So Spinoraptor, do we have a good meat shield? I don't think we have any more. What about a Apatosaur, level 20? 123 bucks. 214. We've really only got a few left. Indominus Rex, Rajastega, Sutropterus. And the thing is, it could be an easy battle. It could be a randomly, like, hard battle. It could just completely step it up out of the blue. So, go for about 1,000 attack max. Come on. Something easy, not too difficult. The last one wasn't. It was, like, 20 VIP. And this time, it is about the same. Yeah, that's good. Okay. So far, we've got lucky. No really super hard, difficult battles just yet. Like it. Keep it that way. And then we can have this video titled Complete Zaxamoxes. Turn it. I don't even know that's... Is that his name? Yeah, of course. Zaxophone. Have we got a Simpson? We're fighting against a Simpson. Awesome. Matt Groening himself. So So yeah, I'm wondering like what the next thing they can do is. I mean, they've added, like, the next big thing we're waiting for. We've got glacier creatures. We've got aquatic. Like, imagine if I could take this game the way it is right now and teleport back to when it was first released and be like, oh yeah, I've got everything. It'd be like Indominus Rex, Erlophosaurus. Are these going to be in the movie? What the hell? Because the game actually came out before the movie was out. So it'd be quite kind of interesting. Oh, that was a lot of damage. Especially for something that's got a disadvantage. That was awesome. Oh, goes for the switch. And goes for one. Wow, that was clever. Why did you do that? Sonya, I'm going to go for full attack. Oh, we've killed it. Bam. And then Scappers comes in and can't even kill us in one hit. This has been an awful team for them. I didn't even need Spinaraptor in here. I didn't even really need Tiny Colossaurus. I could have put in lower level creatures. He has to go for four. He's only got two block. Bless him. Yeah, like, I guess we've got hybrids. We've got glacier creatures. We've got aquatic creatures. All we need now is aquatic hybrids. Like, I'm wondering what else they could do. Like, we've got a year left until Jurassic World 2 comes out. And even then, it'll be interesting. Will Ludia get the rights to another game? Or is it what they're going to do? I'm wondering. Is Jurassic Park Builder, as unfortunate as it was, died. I don't know whether they didn't have the resources to, like, have both going at the same time. Or whether people just stopped playing it and they were like, it's not viable. It'd be kind of interesting to see what the answer behind that was. Because I think it might just be they just couldn't do both. Because if they did Jurassic Park Builder at the same time, then, you know, updates for this game would have been really slow. And yeah, people hate slow updates, so. Another 200 DNA, pretty good. Pretty decent. Very good. If that was in the trade hub, $5 for 200 DNA, I'd take it. So we're getting incredibly close to really good creatures. In fact, we're going to be using them. Sutroptorus and Soprano Titan. Over 1,000 attack each. And then it's going to be Indominus Rex in with whatever. Please be... a very easy team. Oh, Sarcasuka's out first with the advantage. Come on, my son. Go for it. Little ancient crocodile, you. You'll probably switch in to Shunosaurus. Oh, no. Didn't. Oh, no. I think Shunosaurus has like 500 attack. It would have been like well worth it. Because you've only got two and you can't kill me, dude. I'm slowly getting up. Don't be fooled. If I get goes, I'm going to kill you. Don't be fooled by my pitiful attack. Actually, it's pretty darn good, actually. 860 for a regular legendary. That's awesome. It just shows you what the advantage can do. So we've got 8. Sod it, let's attack him. We kill him in 3 hits. Let's go for an extra, like, 3 block. Oh, yes! Awesome! Bam! There you go. If you got Sarcasuchus, there you go. There's a victory for both of us right there. Taking on a level 24 VIP. That's 4 VIP creatures he had to buy to get that. Eesh. And fuse them all together. So, yeah, let's just kill you. I don't even know how many you had left. Probably like 1. I didn't even know. Bam. We'll probably not get too many cups for this because we are way better than them. Could kill me if it wanted to. And it could have, but it went for 1. That I don't understand that. Why would anybody in their right minds go for 1 attack? If it didn't kill the thing. Why would you just, like, that could be a reserve. It could even be a block. 1 attack is going to make no difference. Was he just like, I'll troll? See, I'm acting as if they're real people. But that's the thing with these app games. They always pretend to have real people. They're not, though. It's a false advertising! Oh, we're grinding slowly. We're not going to get there, but we're pretty damn high. And our first pretty naff prize, 60,000 food. It's okay, but, you know, could get better for what we're doing. Especially what we're fighting. So, Skeletor, meow! I've got one to fight, even though other hybrids are way better than me! Against 2,000 Indominus Rex and 1,700 attack, Rajastega. Watch it, we'll be against something incredibly hard now. No, actually, interestingly enough, we're not. Okay. Probably gonna win 20 cups from this because we are way outclassing them. Look at that! Berries max level is the same as a Tropogonathus or Skeletor at level 30. That's crazy. Oh, Skeletor's gonna get a kill though. Just hangs on! I forget we don't have a max Skeletor, do we? I was gonna say, if this was max Skeletor, he's so underpowered. But let's kill it. Rawr!
You like red noses? How about this one? Rawr!
Pterodactylus, beautiful. He's probably going to go for one attack, which is great because I'm pretty sure Indominus Rex can kill him with one. We've got like 2017 attack or something. Come on, please be that. Ah, 74, yeah, it's enough. So we can just easily go for two attacks and one block. Sorry, one reserve. He didn't block, but that's okay. Oh no, Rajastega, you could have been your own, like, battle. Damn it. And it's pretty assured. It doesn't matter what he does. We've killed him. Yum, yum. Boosh. Imagine Jurassic World 2. They have Indominus Rex, but it looks like the one in the game. It would be like, cool, but why, though? And that takes us to... Oh, we got so high then. We could get to level 1. We could get to place 1. And, you know, yeah, I'd rather take the food. Yeah, 30,000. Okay. I mean, if we got another 30 cups, that would take us to 398. Which takes us to rank 13. Oh, let's do it. Let's do it. Sod it, whatever. I don't care if it costs bucks. We've got to do this. So what's the cheapest? You. And then the VIPs are relatively cheap, actually. The VIP creatures, they're awesome for that. You, because you're the new hybrid. Where's Carnoraptor? There he is. That'll do. How about you as a meat shield. You as a good'un. And then a mediocre one, like Carnoraptor. That's awesome. Even if we're against a really good team with, like, Prytrodons, this should be pretty decent. This should be. And there is a Rajastega there! Metrialorn, that's one I keep forgetting to max out. He's pretty darn good. He can't kill me in two hits, though. And Apatosaur level 20. Just shows how awesome this thing is. It's beast. Oh, but he can kill me in three. Is he going to go for it? No! Is it my sheer bulk of a health bar? One to four reserves. You've done good. For a herbivore, you've done amazingly well to hold off that kind of carnivore. Because usually, if it can kill you, it'll go for it. Right, he's got one block. But unfortunately, oh, I can kill you with one hit. So I'm going to have to go for two. Bless it, look at that. That's why a level 30 Gorgosuchus is worth it. Because it can kill a Metrolong level 40 with one hit. That's awesome. Level 40 is just overkill. That's awesome. The fact that it leaves two extra damage. That's... Yeah, they've done that deliberately, I think. Or if they haven't, it's a happy coincidence. So he went for, like, one attack, so may as well go for that. Oh, he's dead! Done, son! Poor Rajastega. You never see those, actually. And Stegoceratops, that's an... You know what we should do is get Stegoceratops. That's one hybrid. It was one of the first hybrids that was released with the original batch. And it's one that I've never gotten. And look at it. It looks awesome. It looks so cool. A maxed one of that would be great. I think that's it. That's my next goal. Because we need good herbivores. And Stegoceratops, it was one of the first ones. It deserves it. So how many cups did we get that time? 29. Pretty darn good. And that takes us to... Like I said, 13. Awesome. We can get to rank 1. It's doable. 90,000 coin. Oh, that's pretty bad. Yeah. That's awful. You want to see me get 90,000 coin? Woo! We've got Cenozoa battles coming soon. I'll show you 90,000 coin. There you go. 116,000. Back to battles. Yeah. Right. Okay, so we've seen that that is pretty OP. So we'll have Micropasaurus, and then one of the best creatures, Metrophodon. And then, you know, just in case things go bad, we'll put in Dinocerus. That team should be enough to conquer anything. apart from, you know, three Metrophodons. And one of them's Gorgosuchus, so that's good. Oh, Uteranus. Uteranus is actually on par health-wise with their regular legendaries. Oh, you think by switching into Gorgosuchus that's going to save you? Oh, it's not. It's not. You're all going to get whitewashed here as soon as Metrophodon comes out. You're all doomed. It's going to happen. Just you watch. It's going to happen. Come on. I dare you.
I dare you. Take out Metrophodon.
Sorry, Macrophosaurus. Go on. Don't take down Metrophodon. Don't do that. That's very bad. Six. Oh, that's it. Yum. You went for a full-on attack. And unfortunately, I can kill you in one, my good sir. Look at that. 5,571 attack. When you get to this point, it's ridiculous. It really is. And go for four reserves, three blocks, and one attack. And he's dead. That's all I needed to do. And I can kill a Ceratosaurus in one hit. And Ceratosaurus is a health tank. Oh my god, that's crazy. Level 40, you don't need it. Level 30 is all you need. It honestly is. Oh, ooh, okay.
Okie dokie.
Actually, that was really risky. Because Uteranus could probably kill us. You know what I'm gonna do? I could have lost that battle there very easily. I'm gonna switch in you. You can go for four reserves and three attack. Why not? Whoosh! Doesn't really make a difference, but, I want him to go for as many attacks as he can. So he's got six, he had seven, he's got one block, so I can go for two attacks. And that's it. That's game. So we'll go for 1-2, and 1-2-3, just in case, and that'll do. Yeah, there you go. Kaboot. And Uteranus has how much attack? Almost 1,000! Okay, yeah, it's better than legendaries. I thought its health, it was like, oh my god, like, T-Rex has that health. But the attack? No. That's an extra half the attack. It's an extra 50%. So we can definitely kill it in one. It only had, like, four block, so, and it did go for it as well. So there you go.
Lick my feet!
You know, out of context, my videos would be really weird.
Be like, berries! Lick my feet! Pecky the eyes!
Oh, yes! There it is! Number one achieved. Okay, now what we're gonna win? Number one prize is, of course, friggin' coin! Oh, God. Well, there you have it, guys. We got to level 1, or rank 1, with 426 points. Within 24 hours, we'll probably be back to Legendary, and we've got to do this for another 6 days, so it'll just be a constant grind. So good luck with the event or the tournament. Hope you managed to unlock this creature, because hopefully it'll be a really good herbivore, because that's what we need. And you can't afford to miss a single tournament creature, because it could have, just like Erlophosaurus, an amazing hybrid. So if you enjoyed this video, guys, leave a like, and until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye!